mission of Kenya Red Cross in the Federation and ICRC, the Ministry of Health was our line ministry. Over time, we have gone to be under the office of the President, but we still have bulk of our work with the ministry, and we collaborate with the ministry quite a lot. So,
you know, in my previous life, I used to work a lot with Kenya Red Cross. So I feel that I think I'm in the right place. It's my pleasure to welcome you to Kenya. Further, I'd like to welcome you to the 7th Annual General Meeting of the new partnership of for African Red Cross and Red Crescent, NIPAC, here at the Boma Hotel, Nairobi, 22nd-23rd June 2013. On behalf of the Government of Kenya, I would like to commend the Kenya Red Cross Society for hosting the partnership and the various Red Cross societies for being reputable and effective humanitarian organizations in Africa. In particular, the Kenya Red Cross has been collaborating with my ministry in the health sector. Of prominent note is the role Kenya Red Cross plays as a principal recipient of the Global Fund, Round 10. I would like to assure you that the Government of Kenya fully recognizes the NIPAC, and it is for this reason that the NIPAC was accorded diplomatic status in 2010. The idea of NIPAC is to promote accountability, transparency, and responsiveness in the continent. This is a mission that all governments should associate with. You will in this meeting, in your deliberation, and look forward to you coming up with more solutions aimed at building resilience in Africa.
Working relationship between Kenya Red Cross and the Kenya government. NEPAC, we believe that in NEPAC, we believe national societies should make effort to be the first port of call to their nation, to their governments.
In 9 years or so, we have had our own challenges, our own successes, but still again, I think when we have a forum like this every 2 years, we have an opportunity of looking into the past, where we have come from and where we are going. How can we make our national societies relevant to the institutions that are being created today in the African Union, within the region, within our own sub-regions, so that we can tap into the resources and opportunities that are there?
We are aspiring to alleviate human suffering in our midst, and at the same time make our national society strong and viable economically, while at the same time maintaining high standards of credibility, accountability, and integrity.